What is your opinion about the educational policies followed by the Modi government in the last 5 years?
When you talk about a success of democracy, it depends upon how much the people are literate and how much they are educated. That is why when a country becomes free, it becomes a republic. The hallmark of that is education is universalized. All are provided education free of cost, especially the school education. In India, after this government came, they wanted to hand over the entire education sector to the market forces. We do not know what happened in Nairobi in 2015 and Buenos Aires in 2017 in the WTO conference, how far they have progressed in negotiations on the offers in the field of opening market access to education. The effect is that the IIT in Chennai, before 2015, fee per annum was 50,000 rupees. After 2015, the fee is 2 lakh per annum. This is only an example. They wanted to hand over the entire sector. That means even the public sector institutions should become self-financed. So the public sector units started losing their public sector character. It is demolishing very big public sector institutions that has been built over many years, and that destruction we saw in this past 5 years.
The central government has cut down the funding for the higher education departments in most of the institutions across India. So in what direction is the government moving with this policy decision?
If you visit the MHRD website even today, you can find a document on new education policy, some inputs for draft education policy 2016. There is a chapter on finance. They very clearly state that the government will not invest to start any new higher education institute, and the government spending will be only for the core area, and for the other areas the student has to meet the cost. They started introducing a concept called world class institute. Later they changed the name of Institute of Eminence. And what is this? The existing private institute and existing government institute will be called as world class. What is the meaning for the change in nomenclature? It's simply the public sector higher education institution loses that character. It will slowly become a self-financed. These kind of institution can charge fee from the students. They will have 1/3 of the students, the foreign students, and 1/3 of staff will be foreign staff. Education is something that is part of culture. They talk about Indianization of education, but they identify English as a language of knowledge. They do not recognize any Indian language as a language of knowledge. Thereby, they on one side, they ensure that education will not be within the reach of the poor people. On the other side, they see the natural death of the Indian languages. When a language is not a language of a medium of education, then how can that language survive? So right from standard one, if you start introducing English as a medium of education, naturally the English Indian languages will die. So on one side you say you want to Indianize the education, on the other side you kill the Indian languages. This is the policy that has been followed for the past 5 years.
Post-matric scholarship for the SCST students has not been disbursed by the central government, and the burden to some extent has been borne by the state government of Tamil Nadu. So this has denied education to the socially oppressed classes in the state of Tamil Nadu in particular. Your opinion on that?
So right from Rohit Vemula, why did Rohit Vemula die? Why the fellowship amount was not given to him? What was the technical problem? Why the technical problem was not solved for more than 6 months? Starting from Rohit Vemula, you can see so many things. What about Muthukishan of Jagavarlal Nehru University? He said, when equality is denied, everything is denied. What is the answer for all these deaths? Almost higher education research has become a standstill. Go to any university, ask them, did they get the UGC grant for conducting a seminar, for conducting a workshop? From 2015, it was nearly a nil, zero. So research doesn't take place. That means how will the quality of the student and the teacher will improve? When they are submitting a paper, both teacher has to prepare and the student also has to prepare. That is why you ask them to conduct workshop. That is why you are asking them to conduct seminar. That means you are bringing down the quality. And regarding the post-matric scholarship for SC/ST, it's a big arrears that is pending from the central government. Naturally, the state is overburdened. State does not pay to the colleges. What happens? The colleges does not issue all ticket. Even if they issue all ticket, if they ask you to write the examination, they don't give you TC. They don't give you mark sheet. You have to run to pillar and post, fight and then get back the mark sheet or the transfer certificate. So this is a big thing that has got. They want to slowly reduce the spending for the education. And they never cared about the upliftment of the poor or the Dalits. If they would have cared, they would have not acted like this.